Good morning, everybody. Today I am going to talk about superposition theorem. Superposition theorem statement is the voltage across or current through an element in a linear circuit is the algebraic sum of the voltages across or current through that element due to each independent source acting alone. Superposition theorem states that in any linear active bilateral network having more than one source, the response across each element is the sum of the response obtained from each source considered separately, and all the other sources are replaced by their internal resistance. The superposition theorem is used to solve the network where two or more sources are present and connected. In other words, it can be stated as if the number of voltage or current source are acting in a linear network, the resulting current in any branch is the algebraic sum of the currents through that would be produced in it, where when each source acts alone while all the other independent sources are replaced by their internal resistances. It is only applicable to the circuit which is valid for the Ohm's law, that is for all linear circuits only. Superposition theorem is based on the concept of linearity between the response and excitation of an electrical circuit. It states that the response in a particular branch of linear circuit when multiple independent sources are acting at the same time is equivalent to the sum of the response due to each independent source acting at a time. In this method, we will consider only one independent source at a time. So we have to eliminate the remaining independent sources from the circuit. We will eliminate the voltage source by shorting their two terminals, and similarly the current source by opening their two terminals. Therefore, we need to find the response in a particular branch n times. If there are n independent sources, the response in a particular branch could be either current following through that branch or voltage across that branch. We can solve the sum by following these steps. Step one, consider only one source at a time and remove other voltage sources. Note, voltage source should be short-circuited and current source should be open circuit. Step two, current in various resistors and their voltage drop due to the single sources are calculated separately. Step three, repeat the process for each source at a time. Finally, the algebraic sum of currents and voltage drop over a resistor due to different sources is taken. Steps for calculation are, we remove one voltage source and calculate the current in the first circuit. Then we add another voltage source and remove the first voltage source and calculate current flowing through this circuit. Then we add both the voltage sources and calculate the total current when we keep two voltage sources. If we add both currents in circuit one and circuit two, it should be equal to the current in the third circuit, which is I1 plus I2. Thank you.